What's up, guys? We are back again in the beautiful Arizona desert once again with the Sonic Dad team to test one more experimental idea with the Sonic Blaster Cannon.
We've got a glass jar, some aluminum foil, and some drain cleaner, sodium hydroxide. We're going to mix these two together with some water and produce some hydrogen gas.
Once that chemical reaction has started, we're going to take this 36-inch balloon, put it over the top, capture that hydrogen gas, tie it off, and then we're going to shoot it with this modified round that has a sparkler in the end. We're going to see what happens.
When we light this and stick it in the cannon, we should be able to hit those hydrogen balloons and cause a big ball of fire. At least that's the idea. Now, I got a request from Tuna Bug to make some kind of a flaming arrow, so I thought with the Sonic Dad team, there's no more perfect opportunity than what we're about to do today. You guys remember how this works? We're going to take some drain cleaner, fill up a glass jar, and then put in some aluminum and add a little bit of water. This is going to create a reaction that generates hydrogen gas. We're going to cap it with a balloon and collect all that gas into the balloon. And I brought some thick welding gloves because this jar is going to get extremely hot. Jake, why don't you take this? You can just go ahead and sprinkle in a bunch of sodium hydroxide until I say stop. Aluminum seems to be the limiting factor, so we're just going to put in more rather than less. That's going to be enough to fill up our balloon, I think. All right, let's add some water. It's not going to be an immediate reaction. That should take off here in about 30 seconds. Now we'll just watch. Look at that reaction! That is amazing! It's bubbling at least 3/4 of the way up the jar, and I'm sure that's getting extremely hot right now. Okay, let's take it off. Ooh, that's hot. It's very hot. Yeah! So check this out. It floats. We got a boomerang balloon. So this is about 2 minutes after I've capped it off. Go ahead and feel that.
Yeah, that would be hot to the touch without gloves. Like, you wouldn't want to hold that.
It's very hot right now. Come check it out, Richie.
Yeah, that's, what, 110 maybe?
Mm-hmm. It's very warm right now. So when the hydrogen is flowing into the balloon, it's actually very, very hot. And as we cap off the balloon and it cools down, the gas shrinks. And so our balloon's quite a bit smaller than when we started. It used to float as well, and now it's not floating as much, and that's because the density of the rubber is pulling it down. But this will still work. There's still quite a bit of hydrogen in here, at least enough to get a good reaction, I think. You hear that? That's all water splashing around inside there. That's the steam condensing and turning back into water inside the balloon. Listen to this. That's why it's not floating. It's got all that water in it. Whoop, it's spilling down my gloves. It's probably not good. And it smells like hydrogen. It smells like success. It smells like we're about to have victory out here in the Arizona desert. If I open the neck of the bottle a little bit, you can see already the condensed water starting to drip out. It's cool. All right, update. Our hydrogen balloon is set. All we have to do now is light off one of our sparkler darts, shove it in the barrel, and send it flying. Let's see if this actually works. My slow-mo's rolling. Richie's gonna let me take the first shot here. Yeah, fire in the hole. 3, 2, 1. Oh!
Yeah!
That was perfect!
Nice!
Yes, that was amazing.
Nice shot.
I couldn't have asked for anything better. You hear that whoomp, all that hydrogen just coming out? It wasn't an explosion, it was a whoomp. It was a big ball of fire. But I still felt the concussion wave. Did you feel that hit your chest? Boom!
That was like a deep bassy thud.
Now, if this was HHO gas, that would have been an explosion. It would have been ear piercing. But because this was hydrogen, it had to diffuse with the oxygen as it burned. And so it probably took about 10 times longer for that burn than if we used HHO. So apparently hydrogen exploding targets are now our thing. We're gonna make them again and again and again. We're also adding a little bit of string here because as the balloon inflates, the hydrogen's lighter than air, and so it may want to float away. Okay, let's get these things lit up. I don't think we have a lot of time to work with. Here we go. We got them. Let's lock and load. Fire.
Did it ignite?
Dude, I don't know if that blew up or not. Now here's the thing, guys. Our theory on why that last one didn't make a big fireball is because the hydrogen was mixed with steam. And so when the sparkler went in, there was a lot more heat energy that had to dissipate through the steam, and so it didn't make the big fireball. Wow, that was actually a lot. It like blasted back toward my face, and I think it caught me on fire for a second, but we're all good. That was hot. I felt that on my knuckles.
It looks hot.
That was awesome. We're all good. No damage here, guys. Let's roll. Rise. Look at that reaction. Bueno, bueno indeed. This way we can watch it from a distance. And my hands aren't burning. Now if this explodes, there's a whole lot of steam in my face, a lot of hot gas. It's starting to get a little bit tighter. I think I'm gonna go ahead and release it. Release the Kraken. Ready the cannons. Okay. Here we go on 3, 2, 1, fire. 3, 2, 1, fire. A little bit of a delayed reaction there, but I heard the whoomp, and I saw that flame come through.
That camera might have saw it real close and personal.
That was good. That was a good amount of hydrogen. I feel very happy about that one.
Is it Grant Thompson approved?
That was Grant Thompson approved. So it looks like igniting giant hydrogen targets is a team effort, guys. Cool. So there you have it, guys. Epic day of experimenting with sparkler bombs and hydrogen targets. We had a lot of fun doing it. Huge thanks to the Sonic Dad team. If you have not checked them out yet, I've got a link down in the description you can click to go to their channel. I've also got a link to the plans for their original marshmallow cannon, so you can download it and try it at home yourself. And a big thanks to Tunabug for suggesting flaming arrows and helping make this experiment happen today. I got 25 bucks coming your way. Thanks for joining us for this experiment today. We'll be looking for you in the next video. Talk to you then. We're blowing up balloons. With science.